What's up, Mini-Z fans? Today, we're going to take this buggy and convert it into a brushless system. This is the brushless ESC that we're going to be using. I'll show you the 8500 kV motor later, and the links are both in the description. Now let's disassemble this chassis a bit and take out the old ESC. First, we'll start with the 5-pin connector, and then take out the brushed motor leads. Now it's time to unscrew the motor mount. Remove the brushed motor from the mount and take note of the orientation of the plastic pieces on either side of it. Remove the last screw holding down the ESC cover. First, we'll desolder the switch. Then we desolder the battery leads. Now we've got to desolder the existing battery leads and switch from the new ESC. I threw something in the previous shot and accidentally turned my soldering iron off, but I don't know that, so watch as I fruitlessly pull and pull at this black lead until I just rip it off the pad. Nothing some solder and copper braid won't fix. Alright, so let's start pulling on these battery leads. They're going to be too short, so we need to replace them. The first red one has a contact on the right hand side and is easily removed. But for the black wire, you're going to need to first remove the shock tower. Now you can pull the switch out and route the black wire down through the suspension out the left side. You don't need to be too gentle, you can use needle-nose pliers to coax it all the way through. Anyways, remove the cover for the receiver on the left-hand side of the vehicle. And now you can desolder the black battery lead. Alright, so there's no more wires in the rear of the vehicle. So it's time to measure some new wires for the battery leads, so that they have enough length to make it all the way to the new ESC. First, we're going to measure the black, and that's going to be 120 millimeters. Then, of course, we need a red lead, and we're going to cut that one to 65 millimeters. Okay, now strip and tin these wires. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, give it a like, and why not subscribe, because I'm going to keep making more. Now add flux to the battery terminals to ensure a good connection. Solder the red wire to the positive battery terminal. Solder the black wire to the negative battery terminal. So pull the black wire and crimp an elbow into it right at about this point, right here. So you're going to route the black wire down to the bottom of the chassis here underneath a black tab. Use your tweezers to thread the black wire underneath the drive shaft and back up to the right side. On either side of the drive shaft, there's some tabs that you'll need to push the wire into. Then you'll want to route the black wire to the top right corner. Down at the bottom, there's another tab, and you'll have to slip it around on the right-hand side of the tab. And once it's in, you can pull the black wire taut upwards. Now route the red and black battery leads through these tabs alongside the ESC. Now reinstall the switch, and then reinstall the shock tower. Let's get our new ESC into position. Then get some more flux and prep the board for soldering. Solder the red wire to the positive terminal. Then solder the black wire to the negative terminal. So if you've been using as much flux as I've been using, you'll want to come back with an alcohol swab and clean all of this up. And an oversight was that I didn't yet solder the switch leads. We'll do it later. We're going to want to reassemble the left-hand side of the vehicle, and first we'll put the receiver cover back on and screw that in. Now let's solder the switch leads as promised. Route the switch wires down the same channel that you did for the battery leads. Slide your old ESC cover over the new brushless leads. You can put the red and the yellow ones on the right hand side and the blue one on the left hand side, and it seems to work just fine. If you run into any issues, you can always knock out the little divider. Take your time closing the ESC cover to make sure that all four wires are able to escape. Once it looks good, screw the ESC cover down. Here it is. The Kyosho Mini-Z X-Speed 85 brushless motor, 8500 kV. And yeah, I opened that box already, but that's how it goes when you're filming stuff. Sometimes you gotta redo a take. So put those little plastic things on in the same orientation as you remembered from before. Oh yeah, go get yourself the pinion from the old brush motor and put that on here too. Put the motor and the shims and the pinion inside of the top of the motor case. Then reinsert the motor case into the chassis. Take your tiny banana plugs from the motor and plug them into the ESC banana plug cups. Wrap the brushless motor leads into a loop and secure it with a small zip tie, clipping it short just like Kyosho does. Be sure to consider how your body will rest on the chassis. Will there be enough room for the wires? So in a side-by-side comparison, here's the Mini-Z Buggy VE with the Inferno clear body. Okay, so it looks like a brushless buggy, but does it drive like one? Oh yeah! If you've got an idea for a mod or a conversion you'd like me to try, leave it down in the comments.